Hello viewers, myself Barsha Sharma, a research scholar from the Department of Geology, B. Borua College. I will be delivering the lecture about the transcription regulation in prokaryotes, but before I begin, I would like to mention that this lecture is being prepared as a part of initiative taken up by Geological Society of Assam to help the students during this COVID-19 pandemic. After going through this lecture, the students will learn about the different control mechanisms of gene expression at transcriptional level, operant model for understanding gene regulation in bacteria, inducible operant system, repressible operant system, and a comparison between the inducible and repressible operant. Let's have an overview of regulation of gene transcription. Gene regulation refers to the mechanisms that control which genes are to be expressed and at which metabolic requirement. Prokaryotic gene regulation occurs when the regulatory proteins bind with the regulatory sequences that are located near the transcription unit. The regulatory proteins can act as an activator mediating the positive regulation, or it can act as a repressor mediating the negative regulation. The negative regulation is mediated by repressor, which blocks or turns off the transcription, whereas the positive regulation is mediated by activator, which increases the rate of transcription. A brief historical background about the discovery of lac operon. The lac operon was indeed a great discovery in the field of molecular biology by two scientists, namely Francois Jacob and Jacques Monod in 1961 from Institut Pasteur Paris. They provided the classic model of operon system in bacteria, which helped to understand the mechanism of gene regulation in bacteria. Both of them were awarded Nobel Prize in Physiology for their discoveries concerning genetic control of enzyme and virus synthesis in 1965. Operon model. Operon model was formulated by Jacob and Monod in 1961 for understanding the gene regulation in bacteria. An operon consists of regulatory genes that are being recognized by the regulatory proteins, and the structural genes which are transcribed into a polycystronic mRNA, and then they are being translated into different proteins. A single promoter can initiate the transcription of all the structural genes in an operon. Inducible operant system. An inducible operant system is an operon which is expressed in presence of a substance called inducer. The lac operon or the lactose operon in E. coli is an example of inducible operant system. In lac operon, lactose and its analogs, that is allolactose and IPTZ, act as inducers, thereby leading to the expression of the lac genes. The lac operon of E. coli contain genes involved in lactose metabolism. In the figure, you can see that the lac operon consists of regulatory sequences, promoter, operator, and the three structural genes lacZ, lacY, and lacA. lacZ produces an enzyme called beta-galactosidase. LAC-Y produces an enzyme called beta-galactoside permease, and LAC-A produces the beta-galactoside transacetylase, whose functions are being described. Beta-galactosidase cleaves the lactose molecule into glucose and galactose. It also converts lactose to allolactose. Beta-galactoside permease transports the lactose inside the E. coli cell, and the function of beta-galactoside transacetylase is not yet clearly known, but it is believed that it protects the cell from buildup of toxic substances by transferring acetyl group to beta-galactosides. Induction of lac operon. In presence of an inducer, that is lactose and its analogs, the inducer binds to the repressor protein and brings about conformational changes in the repressor protein. You can see in the figure that when lactose and allolactose binds to the repressor protein, there is conformational change in the repressor protein which makes it unable to bind to the operator site. As a result, the transcription of the lac genes is turned on. Negative regulation of lac operon. In absence of lactose, the repressor protein, it binds to the operator site and also prevents the binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter, and thereby the transcription of these three structural lac genes are turned off. Positive regulation of lac operon and the catabolite repression. An interesting property of bacteria is that it has distinct preferences amongst the available energy sources in the medium. When glucose is available as energy source, it is catabolized or used in preference to other sugars. The phenomenon of repressive effect of glucose on the synthesis of enzymes that are required for metabolism of other sugar is called catabolite repression or glucose effect. This mechanism involves cyclic AMP and a regulatory protein called catabolite activator protein or CAP protein. Here, both the figures shows the positive regulation of lac operon by the cyclic AMP and CAP complex. In figure A, you can see that in absence of cyclic AMP, CAP does not bind to the promoter and the transcription occurs at a very low rate. In presence of cyclic AMP, CAP protein binds to the cyclic AMP and forms the cyclic AMP-CAP complex, which then binds to the promoter and it increases the RNA polymerase activity and also the RNA synthesis. However, in the figure B, you can see that even in the presence of this cyclic AMP and CAP complex, RNA synthesis is blocked when the repressor binds to the operator region. Repressible operon system. A repressible operon system is a negatively regulated operon system which is inhibited by a regulatory protein called repressor. The best studied repressible operon system is the tryptophan operon in E. coli. Two mechanisms control or regulate the transcription of repressible operon. First is the same mechanism involving the repressor protein as in the inducible operon system, and the second mechanism is known as transcriptional attenuation. Here is the structure of the tryptophan operon. The tryptophan operon consists of five structural genes that are involved in the synthesis of tryptophan from carismic acid. It consists of a promoter site, an overlapping operator site, and a leader region which codes for a leader peptide and an attenuator. Repressor control of tryptophan operon. In the tryptophan operon, the repressor is inactive by itself and hence it is known as the aporepressor. You can see in the figure that in absence of tryptophan, the repressor it gets dissociated from the operator, and as a result, the transcription of the gene continues. Whereas, in presence of tryptophan, the repressor it binds to the operator and thereby it blocks the transcription of the genes of the tryptophan operon. Attenuator control of the tryptophan operon. The leader peptide of the tryptophan operon is involved in the attenuation process. Transcriptional attenuation is carried out by two different processes. First is the translation-mediated transcriptional attenuation, and the second is the RNA-binding protein-mediated attenuation. Translation-mediated transcriptional attenuation. You can see in the figure that when tryptophan is abundant, the moving ribosome, it overlaps the region 1 and 2 of this leader transcript and allows the formation of the stem loop structure between the region 3 and region 4 of the leader transcript. And this structure is known as the attenuator, which finally terminates the transcription of the tryptophan operon. Whereas, when the tryptophan level is low, the moving ribosome, it waits for the first tryptophan codon and it is stalled. The stalled ribosome then permits the formation of the stem loop structure between the region 2 and region 3 of the leader peptide. And thus, it allows the transcription of the tryptophan operon. RNA binding protein mediated attenuation. In Bacillus subtilis, expression of tryptophan operon is regulated by transcriptional attenuation mechanism. This regulation is mediated by a RNA binding protein called TRAP. The formation of mutually exclusive RNA anti-terminator and the terminator structures within the tryptophan leader RNA determines whether the transcription will terminate in the leader region of the operon. You can see in the figure that in presence of tryptophan, the TRAP protein, it binds to the leader mRNA, and then the binding of this TRAP, it causes the formation of this terminator hairpin structure, which prevents the transcription of the tryptophan operon. Whereas, when the tryptophan level is lower, the TRAP protein, it does not bind to the leader mRNA. As a result, the formation of the hairpin structure is prevented and the transcription of the tryptophan operon continues. We'll try to now make a comparison between the inducible and repressible operon. Inducible operon is an operon which normally remains switched off, but repressible operon is an operon which normally remains switched on. The inducible operon is switched on by presence of inducer, whereas inducer has no role in repressible operon. Induction of operon involves removal of repressor from operator gene. But in repressible operon, the repression involves binding of repressor to the operator gene. The regulatory gene in inducible operon forms a complete repressor, whereas in the case of repressible operon, the regulatory gene forms only a part of the repressor, which is known as the aporepressor. In the inducible operon, the induction starts transcription as well as translation. Whereas in the repressible operon, the repression stops transcription and translation. The inducible operon is connected with a catabolic pathway, whereas the repressible operon is connected with an anabolic pathway. These are some references and readings that I have followed while preparing this lecture. So thank you for kindly listening to me, and if you have any queries, you can mail me at my email address that has been provided here. Thank you.